Adding titles, captions, and credits to your video in Movie Maker is pretty straightforward. To add title to your project, select a point in your timeline, typically the very beginning of your project, and then choose Title under the Home tab. This would insert the title automatically. To type your title text, either double-click on the inserted text on the storyboard, or enter the text on the preview window. Notice that since a text element is selected, Text Tools contextual menu will automatically be active in the ribbon. You can change the style of your text by modifying its font type, font size, color, alignment options, and finally the transparency. One of the strengths of Movie Maker is there are a variety of effects you can apply to your objects. The title text is no exception. There is an extensive gallery of effects in Movie Maker. And by just hovering over the effects without selecting it, you can see how the effect actually works. To set the effect you like, just left-click on it. In order to insert a caption, first select the position of your playhead where you would like to insert the caption, and then click on the caption icon under the Home tab. Similar to the title text, you can change the text characteristics of your caption in Movie Maker. You are also able to change the duration of your text object in the storyboard. The default caption duration is set to 7 seconds for text objects in Movie Maker. You may change these values depending on your need. To insert credits text, just click the Credits button under the Home tab. This would automatically insert the credits to the end of the project, regardless of your playhead's position in the timeline. Finally, you can change the position of your caption, title, or credits text by simple drag and drop action. There are two types of animations located under the Animation tab in Movie Maker: transitions, pan and zoom. You can add transitions to each object type, including pictures, videos, and even the titles in Movie Maker. For example, when you apply a transition effect to an object such as picture, you can observe the effect when you move from that particular image to the next object in the timeline. To apply a transition, select your object and click on one of the available transition effects under the transition gallery. When you add a transition, you would see a triangle shape is added to the left of the object on the storyboard, indicating that there is a transition effect applied to that particular object only in the beginning of the picture. On the other hand, once applied, pan and zoom effects are represented with four little squares on the top left of the object. To remove an animation effect, whether it is a transition or pan and zoom, select the object you would like to remove the animation effect from, and then click on None for Transition and None for Pan and Zoom. If you like, you may apply the same animation effect to all objects in your storyboard by using Apply to All button for transitions and Apply to All button for pan and zoom. Similarly, you may use the Control key on your keyboard to do multiple selections of the desired objects and apply the animation effects on them selectively. Visual effects in Movie Maker can only be applied to pictures and video objects in your storyboard. To apply visual effects, make sure you have selected the Visual Effects tab in the ribbon. Select a picture or video frame, and then click on one of the styles available under the visual effect. Similar to other effects in Movie Maker, you can always preview a visual effect first by hovering over it. Once you like an effect, Click on it to apply. Along with visual effects, you have the ability to change the brightness of your pictures and video objects in Movie Maker. All the movie themes are located under the Home tab. There are 7 themes available to choose from. To apply them, just select a theme, and then observe the changes in the preview window. You will notice that an auto theme will add animation effects automatically. Under the Project tab, you have the Audio group where you can adjust some of the audio related to your video. You can emphasize narration, video, or music in your project. By using the audio mix, you can balance the sound between video and your background music in the storyboard. So this tool would allow you to make the music or the video to play louder, depending on your need. The next audio-related icon is called Fit to Music. If you have a long sound clip or music file, let's say lasting for about 4 minutes, and your pictures in your storyboard are set to display only for 3 minutes, by using this feature, you can let Movie Maker automatically adjust the duration of your pictures. The next two options are about the aspect ratio of your video. You can simply adjust the aspect ratio of your movie by making it widescreen, which is 16:9, or standard, which is 4:3. Try to use a 16:9 ratio instead of 4:3 for maximum screen without the black borders around your video. A 16:9 ratio is also preferred aspect ratio for YouTube and HDTVs. It is important to understand the difference between saving a project and saving a movie in Movie Maker. Saving a project in Movie Maker means that you're saving all the elements in your storyboard in Movie Maker original file format, so you can edit your video project later when you need it. On the other hand, saving a movie means actually creating your movie in a playable format and saving it on your computer. This is also called rendering a video. So before rendering or creating your video, you are recommended to save your project first. In order to save your project, click the File menu and select Save Project or Save Project As. Select a location to save your project file, name your project, and click Save. Now we can safely exit the Movie Maker and reopen our project file. When you save your project, Movie Maker creates a file in WLMP format, which is the default format for Movie Maker. To render or produce your final video locally to your computer, just click on the File menu and then select Save Movie. Under this option, you will see Recommended Settings, Recent Settings, Common Settings, and at the very bottom, Create a Custom Setting. If you go over any of these settings, a pop-up window would give you information regarding the setting. This information includes resolution or display size, aspect ratio, bitrate, and file size. The two most important numbers you need to watch here is the display size and the file size. The higher the display size is, you will have better resolution for your movie. For a digital story project, we recommend using 4 computer under common settings. You may also select YouTube setting for your video. Both options will set your resolution to 854 by 480, which should be a good quality for your digital story. If your space is not a concern, you can always go for higher resolutions for your video. To publish a video to some online services, just click on Publish Video on your File menu or find the icons of the service under the Share group in the Home tab.